Now I'm going to talk about the law of total probability. The basic idea is that sometimes computing out the probability of an event A is not very straightforward, but the problem is set up in a way where it's easier to reason about specific cases, okay? And what I mean by that is it's easier to reason about some pieces of the sample space. So here I have blue, orange, and pink. So I'll call those B1, B2, and B3. Okay? So it could be that our problem is set up in a way where it's easy to reason about three special cases. And so what we can do to compute out the probability of A is we look at the part of A that's in B1. Okay, so that here is A intersect B1, and the piece of A that's in B2, A intersect B2, and the piece of A that's in B3, so this piece right here, A intersect B3. And so then the probability of A would just be equal to the sum of these three pieces. Okay? And in general, when we have B1 up to Bn that forms a partition, okay, that means that B1 through Bn don't overlap. So you see these pieces are disjoint, and also they cover the entire sample space omega. Okay, so if I take any two of them, so k not equal to L, I have Bk intersect BL is the empty set, okay? They don't overlap. And the other thing is that if I take the union of all of them, I going from 1 to n of BI, then I will get the sample space omega, okay? And so the general formula is probability of A is equal to the sum from I equals 1 to n of probability of A intersect BI. Okay, and this here is the law of total probability. Of course, this method is only going to be useful if you can actually break up your problem into cases like this. Okay,